welcome to the next part of my DVD collection overview of 2016. Just get straight on with it. Kicking off with some more Michael Haneke. This time we've got The Time of the Wolf, which I don't think I've actually watched that one yet, I'm not too sure. The Piano Teacher, which is my favourite Michael Haneke film. Code Unknown. And yeah, that's the Michael Haneke stuff. Next up we've got Blood on Satan's Claw, which is a nice piece of like gothic Hammer-esque. I'm not sure if it's an Amicus film or what, but yeah. Gorgeous lead, even when she's got the big eyebrows. But yeah, it's that thing that I've talked about a few times. I love these films from the 70s where the women were wearing like these just really white, flimsy gowns that made them look elegant but trashy at the same time. I proper dig that look. But anyway, I don't remember too much about this one, so I'm going to have to revisit it at some point. But that's the Odeon disc that I got really cheap off a Facebook group, I think. Then we've got Import-Export, which is one of my favourite more modern European films. Took me ages to find out what the actual title of the film was, because I remember watching it on like Film 4 back in the UK a few years ago, just after it had been released, actually, if I think back long enough. And it was one of those films that I'd always remembered specific scenes from, but every time I look them up on Google, it just would lead me to something completely unrelated. And then just by chance, I picked this up from FOP, really cheap, because the cover had a sense of familiarity to it. And when I took it back home and watched it, it was that film. So I was overjoyed that I was able to watch that film again. And it's from the guy who did the Paradise Trilogy, which is another great little trilogy. Speaking of great, we've got The Great Silence. This is one of the British releases. This is the release that comes with the Alex Cox featurette, as well as the alternate ending. But yeah, really nice release. I picked that up really cheap. I'm not too sure if it's like the definitive release to get, because I've heard people saying there's a really nice Japanese release. I'm not too sure. But let's have a cup of tea. But I picked that up really cheap on UK DVD. Even though there are a couple of versions out there, so be careful before you put the money down. But yeah, absolutely wonderful bleak western starring Klaus Kinski and Thomas... I can never remember his name there. The French guy. Then we've got Another Empty Space. We've got a French classic with Le Haine, which is Hatred, starring Vincent Cassel. Yeah, shot in black and white, it's grimy, it's gritty, and yeah, it shows you the underbelly and the darker side of Paris, which is always good to see the other side of things. But yeah, phenomenal little film. Then we've got Dogma 2, The Idiots, by Lars von Trier. Really intriguing little film. Again, politically incorrect, antagonistic, frustrating to watch at places. But yeah, I love the Dogma films, well, the ones that I've seen so far. But yeah, fantastic little film if you've never seen it. Then we've got a modern masterpiece with The Hunt, aka Yagtun, is the original title. Directed by friend of Lars von Trier, Thomas Vinterberg, starring Mads Mikkelsen in one of his finest roles. Yeah, I did an episode of Cinema Europe on this one because I just absolutely adore that film. It's one of the few films that genuinely got under my skin. Then we've got the two-disc release of Saturday Night Fever, a film that I genuinely love. I'm not going to class it as a guilty pleasure. I think it's an absolutely brilliant film. Great soundtrack. John Travolta, you know, it's just really awesome. That's all I can say about that. Then we've got Alex de Renzi's infamous Long Gene Silver, starring the wonderful Gene Silver. Yeah, if you want to see a woman violate a man with her stump, then definitely check this film out. But it's actually not like an exploitative film. It shows you that Gene Silver is just as normal as you and I, and it's actually really quite a human tale, which is strange from Alex de Renzi, but there are some weird moments. Then we've got a budget release of Dawn of the Dead that I picked up as soon as I watched it for the first time on TV. I like watched like the last hour of the film, and I just fell in love with it, so that weekend I picked up a DVD. This is a really cheap British version, which comes with a Tom Savini commentary track, which I don't think is available on any other release. I'm not too sure about that, but yeah, I'll always keep hold of that because it's sentimental to me. Then we've got Belle de Jour, which is an absolutely gorgeous film. I'm sorry, an absolutely gorgeous Catherine. Oh, I've forgotten her name. I'm terrible when it comes to recording these videos, but yeah, classy, sophisticated, and an absolutely gorgeous film. Speaking of classy and sophisticated, we've got Thriller Cruel Picture, starring Christina Lindbergh. Why does that name sound wrong to me? Anyway, the exploitation film of exploitation films, put out by Synapse. And yeah, be careful which version you get. Try and get the one that's got the hardcore inserts in there. Doesn't really add anything to the film in a narrative or emotional sense, but it just works well. But yeah, a classic film if there ever was one. Then we've got Eurocrime, Mike Malloy's documentary on the poliziotteschi genre. If you want to get into Italian crime cinema, pick this film up. Get yourself a notebook and pen, notepad and pen, and because you'll be writing down so many titles that are covered in this absolutely fantastic documentary for new and old fans alike. One of the best film documentaries ever. Then we've got DistroPix's release of Pamela Mann. There's the no, that's only the disc two. I don't know where disc one is. Probably further on in this sleeve. Then we've got the opening of Misty Beethoven, which is an absolute classic from Henry Paris. That's Henry Paris' film as well. Then we've got Barbara Broadcast, another classic film, and Maraschino Cherry. I think these are just the additional discs. I must have the actual film discs a bit further on. But yeah, all classic pieces of adult cinema. And it just goes to show you that not all adult cinema and classic porn is trashy, sleazy stuff. Genuine filmmaking there. There's an art and a craft to it. Then we've got 99 Women, Jess Franco, Women in Prison film. This includes the version with hardcore inserts directed by Bruno Mattei. Again, they don't really add anything to the film, but I like to watch that version with them in there. Then we've got a DVD art of Water Power, which was given to me by Genki Slave, who's no longer on YouTube. Quite a few films in my collection are from Genki Slave. Yeah, infamous Jamie Gillis film about a guy who goes around forcing enemas on his victims. Be awesome to see someone like Vinegar Syndrome give this a proper release. That would be a must own for all cinema fans, in my opinion. Speaking of Vinegar Syndrome, we've got a double feature of Winter Heat and Confessions or the Abduction of an American Playgirl. Yeah, I don't know why I just don't twist discs around so I can talk about them properly. Yeah, two nice, nasty films. That's got a nice twist in it, the American Playgirl film. But yeah, Jamie Gillis in that film is sinister as hell. Then we've got Forced Entry, another infamous film from Sean Costello. Basically, it's about Harry Reams stars as like a Vietnam vet who's jaded, he's losing his mind, and he goes around and, causes havoc with people. That's the best way I could put it. Then we've got Freaks and Geeks. Can't remember which one of the series this is, but yeah, Al Goldstein, Midnight Blue. Oh, Midnight Blue. Sorry, Midnight Blue Freaks and Geeks. This is the Freaks and Geeks edition. Great little series of DVDs, from what I can gather. Basically, collecting footage from Al Goldstein's, who, of course, from Screw Magazine, his late night cable like show he did. It's got like loads of trailers, well, not trailers, but adverts from the broadcast. It's got some really interesting. Sorry about that little cut. Basically, ran out of memory on my phone, so I had to delete some stuff. But yeah, Midnight Blue Collection. I'm gonna have to get the other releases in the series because it's just a great little artifact. And of course, the late great Al Goldstein. Very, very politically incorrect, very offensive, but funny at the same time. Then we've got The Hot Nights of Linda, which is released by Severin, which was kindly picked up for me by a good friend here on YouTube, Jason Whitney. Because this is the version of the. This is the release that has the bonus disc, which has like a VHS copy. It's like the VHS version on there as well. They're like French VHS, I think it is. Yeah, Jess Franco. You can't go wrong. Lena Romay. You know what? It makes sense. Then these next discs are the Fog City Chronicles, which is a collection of films, like crime, gangster sort of films. There's a few Italian films on there, some blaxploitation. Pretty much the same as like Mill Creek stuff. The quality is not going to be the best, but for the most part, some of these films, this is the only way you can see them fully uncut. But yeah, if you can look past the dodgy transfers, then you're gonna have a good time, and it's a great set to have. Likewise with the Crime Boss collection put out by Popflix, this includes Confessions of a Police Captain, Death Rage, Crime Boss, Street Law, and Revolver. Yeah, it's just a great way to check out some Italian crime, and you'll save yourself some money. Of course, a lot of these films actually on this release do have proper releases, mainly from Blue Underground. So, for the price you pay for this whole collection, you'll probably pay for either a Blu-ray or DVD from Blue Underground. So, it's a great way to get to know the films to see if you actually need to have them in your collection. Again, transfers aren't the greatest, but who cares? Then we've got SS Girls. Bruno Mathai's Nazi exploitation masterpiece for all the wrong reasons. It's just a trashy, sleazy good time. And the Nazi exploitation genre is one that I'm actually not too big of a fan of, so I really enjoyed that film, and it's one of my favourite Bruno Mathai films. Then we've got Punk Rock and Pleasure Palace, a double feature from Carter Stevens. These are the R-rated versions of the films. The R-rated version of Punk Rock is like a completely different film. It takes the porno stuff out and puts like more story in there and performances from Max's Kansas City, which is, of course, if you're familiar with punk rock music, a very historic place indeed. And yeah, Punk Rock is fantastic in both versions, so you don't need to worry about that. Unfortunately, Pleasure Palace, you can tell that they have cut out the porno in there, but yeah, it's not too much of a inconvenience. And inconvenience, what the hell am I saying? But yeah, good films. Then we've got Malibin by the Malicious Whore, which is released by, I can't remember who released this. I think that's another Severin release, but again, trashy supernatural film. Got some hardcore elements in there, and it's just sleazy as hell. The disc itself is, again, you come across it a lot, but the price some people command for it, yeah, you might not want to pay what people are asking, but it's still an essential film to watch. Then we've got Jess Franco's Justine. This is just the UK, excuse me. The UK Anchor Bay release. Really good film, actually. It's got some trashy moments, but it's got great performances from Jack Palance and Klaus Kinski, even though he's only in it for a little bit. Then we've got Black Magic Rites. This is one of those discs that came free with Dark Star magazine, I think, or something like that. Yeah, I've tried to watch this film a couple of times, but for some reason I've never really been in the mood to finish off watching it. And I've heard that it's a good sleazy time, and from what I've seen, it's got lots of boobs and blood in there, so I'm gonna have to do a proper revisit. And then we've got Gaspar Noé's classic Irreversible. Yeah, that tunnel scene, that's all I'm gonna say. Phenomenal film. And then the final film in this video is The Future Is Unwritten, Joe Strummer, a documentary by Julian Temple. Julian Temple is the master of music documentaries. I love the way he does his documentaries, the way he uses archival footage, the way he uses performance footage. and mixes that in with footage filmed for the documentary. But yeah, an absolutely fantastic director. And even if you're not a fan of the, or you're not aware of the specific artists that he covers in his documentaries are worth watching. And Joe Strummer is one of my idols. The Clash are my favorite band of all time. And the great thing about this documentary is it's not just, oh, Joe Strummer was a great man. Oh, what a wonderful person he was. He never did anything wrong. It shows you him at his best, but also shows you at what he could be capable of in terms of his worst. And I like that. I like that honesty about documentaries like that. So that was this part of the DVD collection overview. If you've seen any of these films, let me know your thoughts and opinions. If you've got any questions about any of the films shown, feel free to ask. But any films that I have reviewed, links will be down below. It's always good to haul yourself out, I suppose. And yeah, I shall see you for the next part. See you guys later.